got it, it ain't a question. Oh, it ain't no room for guessing. No more than emotionally invested. Showing you all my imperfections.
What's up, Survivor Gang? It's your girl, I'm Just Another Weed, and I'm back with another video. Y'all, this is gonna be a quick little video. I was gonna put it on my new news media channel, but I really just want to say this right quick for my audience that I already have a relationship with, or a base audience. Y'all, but it is about a trial that's going on. I know y'all are familiar with the YSL trial, Young Thug trial. So the state have a witness locked up in jail because she didn't, you know, she was subpoenaed to go to court, but she wouldn't like come on her own, so they had to lock her up. The lady said she had already been through so much when the state finally did catch up with her. They said she had went to prison. Her mother got sick while she was in prison. Her mother died shortly after she got out of prison, a day after her birthday. And the state was steady hounding this lady about coming to trial, to court. For one, in my opinion, a trial that should not have even really occurred, because so far they ain't proved nothing to me that YSL is a gang, and that Young Thug just this big time gang leader that tell his boys what to do. From my opinion, all I seen was a bunch of young guys that made bad decisions that didn't see no other way out. However, Young Thug was luckily, you know, blessed enough to be able to get out. And then they bring this stuff back from 10 and 15 years ago. Like, and I'm holding the camera, y'all, so if it's kind of lopsided, y'all forgive me. But I just want to get this out, that when they talked to the girl last, when she was in jail now. She's supposed to testify today. They got her in jail. They caught her with her yesterday. And she's supposed to testify today. The girl says she want to end her life. She want to end her life. She want to unalive herself. And the prosecutor asked her why. She said, because y'all trying to get me to testify to something that I want to do. You mean to tell me the state this hard up on a case that they would, or that they don't care about the livelihood of the next person? Would she say, in her defense, the state prosecution say that she did call an advocate, or, you know, somebody like a suicide advocate when she made that statement? First of all, this is the incidents that they're talking about are either at least 5 to 10, some of them even 15 years old. That man that was on stand, the Bean guy, if y'all familiar with the case, Bean said when he first got on the stand that he was 4 years sober, and that because he suffered from a Molly addiction. And if y'all don't know what Molly is, I guess it's like a pill, I think. I'm not really familiar with drugs myself, but I know the terms and stuff. So I think Molly is like a pill. If I'm wrong, y'all, you know, tell me. But he said he had a Molly addiction and he was clean for almost 4 years. That last day he was on stand, or it may have been the day before his last day on stand, he literally said, I'm so high right now, y'all, I'm about to go to sleep on y'all ass on the stand. I feel like they probably made that man relapse because of this stuff. That guy kept making it known that he had put everything that happened to him in the past, anything from 2013, he said he didn't remember. Now, I don't want people to get on him saying, yeah, you know, them boys did that, they did this, they did that. They may have done it, But if y'all don't know, for the ones that don't know that is not familiar with the case, half of these overacts have either been dismissed, which means they throw them out, or the people have already served time for them. I don't even know how they can bring them back up in this RICO trial. This whole case is a mess, y'all. I just wanted to bring that to y'all attention, that the state. So y'all be careful with y'all lives out here, like seriously, because what you do now obviously can come back and hunt you 10 years later if the state feel like they want to build a case against you. Y'all be careful. It's real out here in these streets. These prosecutors was hounding this girl so bad, to the girl said she wanted to unalive herself. Mr. Bean said they constantly came to his jobs and houses and just constantly looking for her, trying to get him to testify for what I consider a case that shouldn't even be going on. I'm headed home, y'all. I had to run to Montgomery, Alabama to handle some business. So I just wanted to mention that to y'all because I was listening to the trial on my way down the road because they didn't start till like 1 o'clock today. But I'm gonna just wait until till I get home and maybe later on tonight and watch it because I done missed parts of it now. But if you're not familiar with the case, you may not fully understand what I'm saying. But if you do, if you know, you know.
In half a mile, keep left to stay on I-85 North.
I can turn this off now because I really know where I'm at. I don't know if y'all heard that, but my GPS was talking. But I know where I'm at now, which is on the straight interstate. But yeah, y'all, that's what I wanted to say. Do the state really go to any lengths to get their point across?
Keep left to stay on I-85 North.
They don't really care about your well-being. Y'all comment down below for the ones that's been following this case in Timmy.
Continue on I-85 North for 52 miles.
Bye, y'all. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm going to be putting some new videos out on my news media channel. I did get a name for it. Y'all voted. For the ones that voted, I thank y'all so much. So Netta News LLC will definitely be kicking off in full force. All right. But y'all don't forget about this Lynetta Williams, because this is going to be my main page where I still do a lot of my main, you know, stuff on. Like I said, I got some things I want to work with Miss Ambria Nicole and Beautifully Healed. You know, a lot of people I want to work with. So y'all just definitely don't forget about this channel, but definitely check out my new news media channel because I got some stories for y'all. All right, y'all. I see y'all. Let me concentrate on this road and get on back to Opelika. All right. Bye, y'all.